Hi everyone. The new forms experience in SharePoint is extremely easy to use. So you can create a form and then collect inputs and store it in a SharePoint list or Microsoft lists. Now, there is an easy trick that you can use to embed the form in a SharePoint page and then in Microsoft Teams if you want, instead of sharing the link with users. Okay, let me show you how this thing is done. Let's go. Here I am in one of my SharePoint site collection. To be more precise, I have the global HR communication site open and I have this list travel requests with approvals. I would like to create a forms for this list using the new form experience. Let's hit the button forms, then let's create a new form. Travel request. I'm going to reuse all existing columns that I have on my list and then I can click on the button send form to publish this form to make it available to all the people that I want. Now I copied also the link and what I'm going to do right now is embedding this form directly in the SharePoint home page. So I'm going to reuse an existing area that I have here. So let me edit this page. So before to add the proper web part, what I will do is creating the right HTML tag that I need. And I'm going to open the notepad that I have here. This is the HTML markup that I need to add to my web part. I pasted here now the URL to open the form of my list. Now I'm going to copy the full markup and let's go back to the SharePoint site and here I can add, for example, now a new section if I want, but let me reuse this existing section and let me add now the proper web part. In this case, the web part that I will use is the embed web part. Now on the properties panel, I can add my iframe in this text area. So let me open the copy paste panel of Windows and I'm going to paste here my iframe. Now, as you can notice, I have this warning message. It seems that my HTML markup is incomplete. This because SharePoint expects to see two properties, a couple of properties, which is width and height. So let me add this one, let me type 800 and then it's not finished yet. I need to add also height. In this case, it would be, let's say 600. Now it should be complete. I can see now the forms loading and it's available now in the page embedded. I can click now on the button republish the homepage, and now I'm able directly from here, I have this little area, so now I can start to play a bit better with this layout. So let's say that this is not the best option for me, so what I'm going to do is drop this thing here and let's see if it looks a bit better. So let me republish now the page and my form now is placed on the left column of this section so I can better fill out now the content of this form. I have on the left the travel request form and on the right the documents library. Now we'll create another section here. This would be a one column so the form will have more space. Let me drag and drop here the form that I created and now I will click on the button republish. So theoretically I will have now more space for this form so I can enjoy this form in full view. I am now in Microsoft Teams under the Global HR team. I will click on the apps channel and here by clicking in the upper right corner open apps, what I will do is adding the SharePoint app. Pin SharePoint to this channel and now I'm going to target the homepage of this site collection, which should be So let me go on any SharePoint site. Now let me copy this link and let's click on save. And now this page, this SharePoint page, of course, will be here available and embedded with my form. I can do more. So I can create another hub here and I will use this time the website hub. So let's click now on pin website. Here I can type, for example, travel request form. And now here in the URL, I am going to paste the URL of my form. So let's hit the button save. Now I have the first SharePoint page that I created before. So let me close the property panel. So let me remove now this app. And let me go on a travel request form. This will open directly in the web browser, the form. So it's up to you how you prefer to have this experience. All right, I hope you enjoyed how you can embed forms in SharePoint pages. If yes, please consider to subscribe, like, add a comment down below. Let me know if this trick is helpful for you. I hope to see you next time. Bye.